Hi there, Libra, and welcome to this week's Modern Shaman Maria in RainbowLand for the weekly forecast for the Libras for the week that starts at the 17th of July and ends at the 24th. I'm here in one of my new creations. I know that you like the art, so this is my walking art creation from RainbowLand. They love it here in Japan. They are crazy about colors and new things. Maybe you are too. If not, so weird. No. Okay, so let's start this week. I'm Libra rising, just for the record, and most of my family is Libra, so I have a very good understanding of where you come from. So last week's lunar solar eclipse, partial solar eclipse, is probably still ringing in your head. This may be something about you wondering how to help someone from the family. Maybe there's an issue with some relatives, your father, who knows, authorities of some kind, because it's between your 4th and your 10th house that this was going on. Your 10th house of Cancer, which is the spotlight of the horoscope, where you are on stage showing the world what you can in an assertive way, making a difference. So maybe you're still pondering upon things to do with these things. You just have to know that there's a steady progress always going on, and trust that things are like they're supposed to be, because we attract what we are, the energy we are, not what we say, not this and that, but the collection of energy that we are is through the law of attraction we are attracting. So it's very simple. Therefore, we are being forced sometimes, to really see what is attracting bad things. And when life is, suddenly, just like the tower card in the tarot, you know that card? It's a tower, it's burning, people are, jumping out of the windows, there's nothing to do, the building is falling down. And we have Uranus in your 8th house, Taurus. So these are very deep, deep transformations within you going on. And since it's Uranus, there can be certain things where you really, truly need to, trust that, okay, there's a reason for this. And you're always about, but is it fair? It can conflict sometimes, but this is not fair that this is happening to me, this feeling. But you have to trust that there is a fairness. There is, the right things are going on. We attract what we are, not what we say. We attract what we give out. So just remember that if there's something that seems unfair, try to ask yourself if you somehow could have attracted it. I know this sounds hard, but it's just a way of getting out of the victim role state so that you can change it fast. And sometimes we also hold on to some patterns that feel safe for us because we know them. So these may be times where you feel like you're moving into unknown territory, and that feels, also with your family situation, and you have a lot of work to do. There's so much on your plate that you get a little stressed out, because what about your personal life? Where will it end? And sometimes we just have to trust that we are going in the right direction. And this is what I see for you guys. You are going in the right direction. So within the next 2 years, things will be changing also family-wise in a way that you will love and appreciate. You just need to trust that there's a steady progress and go for it. Whenever, life tells you to be focused upon that or focused upon that, then receive the messages and go for what feels right. Your planet is in the 12th house, so definitely 12th house of Virgo. It went in there last week. So maybe you get a little extra sentimental, and thinking about things from the past. And again, you need to let go of things. Maybe people from the past are coming into your life to show you a pattern. Just like also through your dreams, you can dream things that will alter things in your life in a beautiful way. And you know, when you dream about someone, let's say an ex-boyfriend, an ex-girlfriend, and she comes into your dream and you think, oh no, now do I want to be with her again? No, she's just representative of something inside of you that you haven't dealt with. So ask yourself, this person that comes in, what do they represent? Instead of thinking, oh, maybe I should be with this person again or whatever. Then think, what do they represent for me in my life? And then look upon that thing. It's forming a great aspect, Venus, to Jupiter in your second house. So maybe something, a good deed that you did in the past for someone, and that person coming back is going to help you improve your financial situation, because Jupiter is moving forward in your second house of your values and your finances. So maybe some good things will be going on in your financial sector that will help you improve that part of your life, which is, has been undergoing a great change over the last several years. But now it's coming to an end, all the change, in a good way, and now Jupiter is, you know, putting a light upon what else can be done within this sector of your scope. Then we also have a first quarter square of the moon between the sun in your career house, and then the moon in your own house, the first house, your own sign. So this is something about with your identity, where maybe you come into some kind of a conflict or confrontation between you and someone from work that may confront you with something. And since Venus, your planet, is also in opposition to Neptune, it may be someone who this week and the later part of the week, the other thing is too, this may indicate that someone is not, you know, maybe someone is a little elusive or evasive. I mean, the Neptune is the veil, is the fogginess, it's the drunk person, it's the one on drugs, it's the one talking about something that's dreamlike and not really realistic. So someone may seem too good to be true with whatever they're saying, or that person who are criticizing you is just someone who will give you the opportunity to learn to stand up for yourself and say no. Simply, no. The Libras don't have to always explain, like I'm doing now with 100 words. Sometimes we just need to learn to say no, when no is needed, instead of pleasing. That's a good place to end it, isn't it? Sun is going into Libra as well, I have to mention that. So we'll have a change where we'll come into your 11th house and make you focus more upon what you can build in the future. So remember, first and foremost, don't follow trends. Follow your heart. And remember to see the weekly collective forecast. Weekly collective forecast, top section, first playlist I have on my channel. The first collective report there will show you a little bit more about what's going on around you. Thanks for watching. Your modern shaman, Maria and RainbowLand, checking out. Yeah. See?
jeg er.